predators. They're not just hanging around in alleys. They could be around the corner or right behind you waiting to attack in the middle of the day.
So what do you do if a criminal attacks? How can you avoid being a target? Music's Caitlin Smith takes us through some real life situations and shows us how to react.
Growing up, Elizabeth Boyer's dad told her not to hit. But now she's a college freshman who wants to be able to fend for herself.
It feels really good to be given permission. Because as a female, you're not often taught, you can punch someone.
This self-defense course at Elizabethtown College teaches you to have a plan and have the moves to back it up. It puts you in real-life situations, like standing at the ATM.
Please enter the amount of withdrawal you would like at this time.
One of the instructors poses as the machine. An elbow to the face frees her this time. The padding allows Elizabeth to go all out.
I can't even imagine how much worse it would be in an actual attack situation. But if this makes me shaky and nervous, but yeah, it feels good.
Good to know what to do if attacked and how not to be a target.
Defensive stance.
No.
On ready.
I tend to use the analogy of a lion hunting a herd of zebra.
Just take a look around. He says criminals are watching for someone walking alone, distracted, maybe on the phone or listening to music.
They're looking for easy. They're not stupid. They may be bad, but they're not stupid.
Awareness is your best weapon.
Just walking with confidence, making brief eye contact, letting anyone know, yes, I see you're there and I recognize you. Worst case scenario, if I needed to, I could identify you later.
And if you choose to carry an actual weapon like mace,
it's just like any other weapon that you're going to carry, you need to have the proper training. Little things like, oh wait, there's a breeze blowing this way. I don't have the luxury of telling that bad guy, can we turn around and you attack from this direction? Because if I spray that pepper spray, it's going to come back and get me.
So make sure you practice. He recommends using silly string instead because it's similar to mace. And make sure you hold it in your non-dominant hand. That way your other hand is available if you need to punch. And while you're spraying, he says to be sure to move side to side.
In the heat of the moment, you don't know what you're doing.
All right, defensive stance.
Unless you make it second nature. And that's what training like this is all about. Yes, her dad always told her not to hit. But now she's hitting him. Elizabeth's dad is in the red suit. He's the director of campus security. He says the technique his little girl is learning in here will give her the upper hand against someone bigger out here. In Lancaster County, Caitlin Smith, News 8.
And the class you saw there is called RAD. It stands for Rape Aggression Defense Systems.
And some other tips from the head of campus security: carry a false wallet, one you could hand over to a criminal. He also says if you should have a code, you should have a code phrase with family members, roommates, or coworkers so that they can tell if you're in an actual emergency situation. Not a bad idea. Yeah.